Today we are going to study about entropy. The expressions for entropy, change of entropy during reversible and irreversible change, and also we'll study the principle of increase of entropy. We have seen in our last lectures what is entropy and the second law of thermodynamics. Entropy was a term first used by Rudolf Clausius to state the second law of thermodynamics. It is taken from the Greek word tropy, which means transformation. So we'll find what is the entropy, the change in entropy, and what is the concept of entropy. So for that, let us consider this figure. It is a PV diagram where L and M are the adiabatics, and A, B, C, D, E, F, these are the isothermals at temperatures T1, T2 and T3. So we'll consider the isothermals T1, T2 at temperatures T1, T2 and T3, which are drawn on the adiabatics L and M. Let A, B, C, D and D, C, E, F. So we have here A, B, C, D. This is A, B, C, D and the D, C, E, F, this one. These represent the Carnot's reversible cycles. So, we'll consider the first reversible cycle, that is A, B, C, D. Now, during this Carnot's cycle, the amount of heat absorbed is Q1 at temperature T1. So, let us take that Q1 is the amount of heat absorbed at temperature T1 here. And the amount of heat rejected is Q2 at temperature T2. So then we can find the efficiency of Carnot cycle, as we have seen in our last lectures. It is given by Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1 is equal to T1 minus T2 upon T1. So we have here Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1 is equal to T1 minus T2 upon T1. Or we can write this as, अगर आपने इसको थोड़ा सा सॉल्व किया तो आप इसको ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं, इट इज़ 1 माइनस क्यू टू अपॉन क्यू वन इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस टी टू अपॉन टी वन. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो मैंशन दिस एज Q2 बाई Q1 इज इक्वल टू T2 बाई T1, एंड वी कैन रीअरेंज दिस एंड राइट एज Q1 बाई T1 इज इक्वल टू Q2 बाई T2. लेट अस नेम दिस एज इक्वेशन नंबर 1. सिमिलरली वी विल कंसिडर second Carnot cycle DCEF, and from this we get the expression Q2 by T2 is equal to Q3 by T3. If we take Q2 as the amount of heat absorbed and Q3 as the amount of heat rejected, and then we can write this as Q2 by T2 is equal to Q3 by T3. So from equation 1 and 2, what do we find? That Q1 by T1 is equal to Q2 by T2, which is equal to Q3 by T3. This can be taken, the ratio can be taken as constant. So in general, if we take Q as the amount of heat absorbed or rejected at temperature T in going from one adiabatic to another adiabatic, we can write that Q by T is equal to constant. Now suppose the two adiabatics are very close to each other. ये जो adiabatics हम लोग ले रहे हैं, suppose these two adiabatics, they are very close to each other. So this L and M, if they are very close to each other, then we can say that take a small amount, जैसे कि del Q आप ले सकते हैं, del Q as a small amount of heat absorbed at constant temperature T, then we can write this del Q by T is equal to constant. Now this is the ratio which is called as the change in entropy between the states. So it is called as a change in entropy between the states, which is represented by two adiabatics. Now it is generally denoted by del S. So we can write this as del S is equal to del Q by T. The change in entropy for finite reversible change in the state of a working substance from A to B. If you want to write the same thing, suppose we are moving from A to B, then we can write this as integration from SA to SB dS as equal to integration from A to B dQ by T. And the left hand side can be written as SB minus SA, and that will be equal to integration A to B dQ by T. Now this expression integration A to B dQ by T, which is equal to integration of SA from SA to SB TS, it is a function of thermodynamic coordinates of the system. This function, it is represented by symbol S, which is called as the entropy. So, this is called as entropy. Now, DS is an exact differential, and entropy, as we have seen, is an extensive property because it depends on the mass of the working substance. So, we can write this as entropy is an extensive property as it depends on the mass of the working substance. Now, we will find the entropy changes in irreversible and reversible processes. So, first let us find the change of entropy in the reversible cycle, that is the Carnot cycle. So, let us find out the expression for the change of entropy in a reversible cycle, because we have two types of cycle, and one is the reversible and the other is irreversible. Or reversible cycle ka example humne dekha tha, Carnot cycle, it is a reversible cycle. So let us consider complete reversible Carnot cycle ABCD, which is as shown in this figure, and the curve AB and the CD, they are the isothermals at temperatures. This AB and CD, they are the isothermals at temperature T1 and T2. And these curves BC and AD, these are the two adiabatics. So, we have four processes. We have seen earlier that there is isothermal expansion, then adiabatic expansion, then isothermal compression and adiabatic compression. So, during these four processes, let us try to find out what is the change in the entropy. So, the first process is isothermal expansion AB, along the curve AB. So, we can write this as, suppose we take Q1 as the amount which is a heat which is absorbed at high temperature T1 during this isothermal expansion from the A to B. The increase in entropy of the working substance will be given by. Now, we can write integration from A to B, because the working substance is taken from the states A to the state B. We can write this as integration from A to B dS as equal to Q1, because Q1 is the amount of heat which is absorbed and T1 is the temperature. So, therefore, we can write this as Q1 upon T1. Now, we will go for the second state, that is the adiabatic expansion BC. Now, during this adiabatic expansion BC, we have seen that there is no change in entropy of the working substance, but the temperature falls from T1 to T2. So, therefore, due to expansion, and we can write this as integration from B to C dS will be equal to 0. Now, the third state is that isothermal compression, which is along CD. So, isothermal compression, this is along CD. The working substance will reject heat Q2 to the sink at temperature T2. So, here it was adiabatic, no heat loss or gained, and that's why the change in entropy was 0. Here it is isothermal again compression, and the amount of heat which is rejected is Q2 at temperature T2. The entropy of the working substance decreases, and the change in the entropy will be given by integration from C to D, that is equal to minus Q2 upon T2. The fourth state is adiabatic compression, which is along the state this dA. In this process, again, there is no change in entropy because there is no change of heat and exchange of heat, and therefore, again, the change in entropy will be equal to 0. So, integration from this D to A, dS will be equal to 0. Now, to find the net gain of entropy for the working substance in the whole cycle from A to B, C, D and back to A, we will add up all of these expressions. So, the net gain in the entropy of the working substance in the whole cycle will be equal to sum of all these expressions. So, integration of dS can be written as integration from A to B, dS plus B to C, then C to D and D to A. Let us put up all the expressions here. When you put up all the expressions, you will find that integration of dS will be equal to Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2, because these two terms, they are 0. And for a reversible Carnot cycle, earlier we have seen that for a reversible Carnot cycle, this Q1 by T1 is equal to Q2 by T2. Iske pehle abhi thodi der pehle humne dekha tha. Q1 by T1 is equal to Q2 by T2. And therefore, because these two are equal, now the subtraction will be equal to 0. And therefore, for a अब वी कैन राइट दिस क्यू वन बाय टी वन माइनस क्यू टू बाय टी टू इज इक्वल टू जीरो, एंड देयर फोर द नेट चेंज इन एंट्रोपी डेल एस विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो. दस वी कैन से दैट इन ए साइकिल ऑफ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस द एंट्रोपी ऑफ द सिस्टम रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड और इट रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट, एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट द टोटल चेंज इन एंट्रोपी इज ऑलवेज जीरो फॉर ए कंप्लीट रिवर्सिबल साइकिल. So this we have to remember that the change in entropy is always zero for a reversible process. So reversible process जब भी देखेंगे हम लोग उसमें हमेशा change in entropy will be equal to zero. अब reversible process में तो entropy change zero हो जाता है, तो let us find out what is the entropy change during an irreversible process. To find the entropy change during an irreversible process, let us consider an irreversible cycle now. इरिवर्सिबल साइकिल, हमने बहुत सारे इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस देखे हैं जिसमें कि जो सब्सटेंस है वो वापस ओरिजिनल स्टेट पे वापस नहीं आता है. एंड लेट अस से दैट सपोज वी हैव एन इरिवर्सिबल साइकिल इन विच क्यू वन इज़ द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एब्जॉर्ब्ड एट टेम्परेचर टी वन एंड क्यू टू इज़ द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट विच इज़ रिजेक्टेड एट टेम्परेचर टी टू, एंड देयरफॉर वी कैन से दैट द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ दिस इंजन दिस टाइप ऑफ साइकिल विल बी गिवन बाय Q1 minus Q2 upon Q1. Now, according to Carnot's theorem, the theorem which says that the efficiency of irreversible cycle will always be less than the efficiency of a reversible engine. So, if suppose we take a reversible engine whose efficiency which is working between the temperatures T1 and T2, then its efficiency can be written as eta is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. तो इरिवर्सिबल साइकिल या इरिवर्सिबल इंजन की एफिशिएंसी हमेशा रिवर्सिबल इंजन से कम होती है, और इसलिए हम इसको लिखेंगे ऐसे Q1 माइनस Q2, दिस वाज द एफिशिएंसी फॉर इरिवर्सिबल इंजन एंड दिस इज़ द एफिशिएंसी फॉर द रिवर्सिबल इंजन. तो हम इसको लिख सकते हैं कि Q1 माइनस Q2 अपॉन Q1 इज़ लेस देन T1 माइनस T2 अपॉन T1, एंड देयरफॉर यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट दिस एज 1 माइनस Q2 by Q1 is less than 1 minus T2 by T1. Now we can say if suppose it is 1 minus Q2 by Q1 less than 1 minus T2 by T1, then the sign gets reversed if you remove the 1 from here, and therefore you will get this as Q2 by Q1 is greater than T2 by T1. Or you can write this Q2 by T2, if you rearrange this, you will get Q2 by T2 is greater than Q1 by T1. So it means that this difference Q2 by T2 minus Q1 by T1 is greater than 0. So we can say that Q2 by T2 minus Q1 by T1 is greater than 0. Now if you take whole of the system of the irreversible cycle, you will find that the source it loses an amount Q1 by T1 and the sink gains an amount Q2 by T2. तो ये माइनस साइन क्या शो कर रहा है कि सोर्स जो है इतनी एंट्रोपी को लूज कर रहा है और सिंक जो है इतनी एंट्रोपी को गेन कर रही है. सो वी कैन राइट दिस एज सो व्हेन यू टेक द होल ऑफ द सिस्टम द सोर्स इज लूजिंग एन अमाउंट Q1 बाय T1 एंड द सिंक इज गेनिंग एन अमाउंट Q2 बाय T2. देयरफॉर द नेट चेंज इन एंट्रोपी फॉर द होल सिस्टम विच विल बी Q2 बाय T2 माइनस Q1 बाय T1 इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो. द नेट चेंज विल बी ग्रेटर देन जीरो which is which says that it is greater than zero, it means it is positive. So thus we see that in an irreversible cycle there is always gain of entropy, that is ds is greater than zero. तो ये हमें याद रखना है कि अगर irreversible cycle है तो उसमें entropy हमेशा gain हो रही है, और अगर reversible cycle है तो उसमें change in entropy जो है वो zero रहती है. तो आइए अब देखेंगे हम लोग कि principle of increase of entropy क्या है. तो इसी के बेसिस पे हम लोग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंक्रीज ऑफ एंट्रोपी बता सकते हैं. सो फॉर दैट वी आर कंसिडरिंग एन इंजन विच इज़ परफॉर्मिंग इरिवर्सिबल साइकिल. तो हम एक इंजन कंसिडर करेंगे, जैसे कि ये सपोज एक इंजन है जो कि इरिवर्सिबल साइकिल परफॉर्म कर रही है, और इसमें वर्किंग सब्सटेंस जो है Q1 अमाउंट ऑफ हीट को एब्जॉर्ब कर रहा है टेम्परेचर T1 और फ्रॉम द सोर्स, एंड Q2 अमाउंट ऑफ हीट जो है वो रिजेक्ट कर रहा है सिंक को एट टेम्परेचर T2. तो इसकी आप एफिशिएंसी लिख सकते हैं. द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ दिस साइकिल विल बी गिवन बाय eta dash, which is equal to q1 minus q2 upon q1, and this is equal to 1 minus q2 by q1. फिर से हम देखेंगे कि कर्नोट साइकिल क्या कहता है, कर्नोट्स थ्योरम क्या कहता है. कर्नोट्स थ्योरम ये कहता है कि कोई भी इरिवर्सिबल इंजन की एफिशिएंसी जो है हमेशा रिवर्सिबल इंजन की एफिशिएंसी से कम रहेगी, और अगर दोनों सेम टेम्परेचर्स के बीच में काम कर रहे हैं तो भी. सो वी कैन से दैट फॉर ए रिवर्सिबल इंजन द एफिशिएंसी विल बी ऑलवेज हाई. सो वी कैन से दैट फॉर दिस ईटा डैश विच इज़ द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ ए irreversible engine is always less than the efficiency eta of a reversible engine. तो इसको हम फिर से mention करेंगे, 1 minus q2 by q1 will be less than 1 minus t2 by t1. और फिर हम उसी तरह से solve करेंगे, q2 by q1 is greater than t2 by t1 और q2 by t2 is greater than q1 by t1. या फिर आप इसको लिख सकते हैं कि q2 by t2 minus q1 by t1 is greater than 0. अब फिर से हम कंसिडर करेंगे कि पूरा सिस्टम अगर आप लेते हैं तो उससे आपको पता चलेगा कि इसमें ये जो पार्ट है q1 by t1 इट इज़ नेगेटिव. इसका मतलब कि सोर्स इतनी जो वैल्यू है एंट्रोपी की वो लूज़ कर रहा है और सिंक इतनी एंट्रोपी को गेन कर रहा है. सो दिस इज़ द अमाउंट विच इज़ लॉस्ट बाय द सोर्स एंड दिस इज़ द अमाउंट q2 by t2 विच इज़ गेन बाय द सिंक. तो नेट चेंज इन एंट्रोपी जिसको कि हम लिखेंगे q2 by t2 माइनस q1 by t1 जो कि ग्रेटर देन ज़ीरो है, इसका मतलब कि वो पॉजिटिव है. और ये ऐसे ये पता चलता है कि इरिवर्सिबल जो प्रोसेस है इसमें इंक्रीज़ हो रही है एंट्रोपी की, सिस्टम की जो टोटल एंट्रोपी है वो इंक्रीज़ हो रही है. सो दस देर इज़ एन इंक्रीज इन एंट्रोपी ऑफ द सिस्टम ड्यूरिंग एन इरिवर्सिबल. सो From this we can also define the principle of increase of entropy. So this is an important point that we have seen that for the entropy of a system increases in all irreversible process. इसी को हम लोग कहते हैं law या फिर principle of increase of entropy. And for all natural processes taking place in the universe are irreversible. It means that the entropy of the universe increases. अब आपको पता है कि जितने भी नेचुरल प्रोसेसेस है वो सभी इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस है, तो इसका ये मतलब होता है कि सभी टोटल एंट्रोपी हमेशा बढ़ ही रही है, तो यूनिवर्स की जो एंट्रोपी है वो इंक्रीज हो रही है. तो इसको हम लोग लिख सकते हैं ऐसे, ds ऑफ द यूनिवर्स इज़ ऑलवेज इंक्रीजिंग विच इज़ ग्रेटर देन ज़ीरो. सो दिस इज़ हाउ वी कैन एक्सप्लेन वाई देर इज़ इंक्रीज इन एंट्रोपी ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. सो दैट इज़ ऑल फॉर टुडे. वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर the second law of thermodynamics in terms of entropy, and we'll see the TS diagram and the derivation of work done and efficiency from in terms of this TS diagram also, and we'll also see the third law of thermodynamics that will finish up this chapter, that this unit, and then we'll start the next unit.